that we made and that we anticipate making, and I'm going to give an outline of what our full schedule is between now and when we send it to a vote. I'll start with the schedule. Tonight is the public meeting. Next 2 weeks, we'll discuss any of the input that comes out of here. Then the 10th, we will, the town meeting, we won't be meeting at all. 15th through the 29th, the town council will review what we've done. The 24th, assuming town meeting is over, we will start meeting again. And then December 1st, and we're hoping to have everything to town manager by the 4th. So then we can get the background information ready. December 8th, the warrant articles go to the board of selectmen. The 9th, the warrant closes. 10th, the town bylaw committee votes. 15th, the warrant goes to print. Warrant available on the 18th. Then we will finalize our presentation between the 8th and the 22nd, and town meeting is scheduled for January 5th. That's when it will go to town meeting. The idea is we'll probably have 5 separate articles, one main article for most of the changes. And then there are 4 that we need to have go to the legislature, because even though they're relatively minor changes, because they deal with things that a charter committee in the town meeting isn't allowed to touch, the terms of office of the board of selectmen, the town meeting, the town manager, or anything to do with elections. Making relatively minor changes to the elections, which we'll talk about in a minute. With that, I think we'll just quickly go through Articles 1 and 2. The changes we've made there aren't all that heavy. And then we'll have a little bigger presentation on Articles 3, 4, and 5. Article 1, we have changed basically just the word. For example, the division of power. It currently says all legislative powers of the town shall be exercised by a representative of town meeting. We have just reworded that to say a representative of town meeting shall exercise all legislative powers. We've changed the Commonwealth to Commonwealth of Massachusetts. That's it. Just to clean up the document.
If I might.
Yes.
Just explain the powers.
I'm sorry, I didn't realize.
Blue is old language crossed out. Red is new language that has been voted in by the Charter Committee. And then green is things that are still under discussion, or it may footnote a whole section that's still under discussion.
Green is things that we've not voted on yet.
Yeah, absolutely.
Now, on that division of powers, I think you might want to insert the word have.
Section 2, we did similar things. As you do copies, you can see what we've done there. Sections that will have to go as a separate article because it deals with town meeting membership. What we're doing there is
you're changing the tiebreaker.
Oh, right, changing the tiebreaker. So since it's a change to our legislative body, that has to go to the legislature or the town as a whole. We figure that it's a relatively small change. We're going to ask the legislature. Will change for us. And that's the same with the nomination procedures, 2-5. Precinct meetings, we straightened out a little bit there. What we've done is to just solidify how the precinct meetings work and what officers they have to elect. Finance Committee, we made a little bit of heavy change there. Currently, Finance Committee members can serve no longer than 9 years. So if you come in the middle of a term, you can serve that term out and then 2 or 3 year terms and cannot be appointed again. what we've done is allow that if you serve less than 2 years of a term that someone else was appointed to, that would not count toward your 9 years.
Let me add to the both committees' benefit something you had asked me last meeting. This version reflects a discussion with town council and I on how to describe boards, committees, commissions, etc.
Oh, right.
So his suggestion, and I like it, was to refer to the generic thing as boards or committees. So boards or committees in the definition, the list, it can be any number of these things or any other section. So you'll see in the tables of contents and other sections, instead of saying boards, committees, and commissions, we'll just say boards or committees, and everyone will understand that can be a whole lot of things, like the council on aging.
We had you possibly use the term multiple member bodies.
And he hated that. He said it sounded like a science fiction. So he suggested boards and committees will take care of that. So that's the changes I made in green.
Okay, thanks for that. That's awesome.
You can see that in 213, which used to be establishment of standing committees, I guess. And he just said, you know, just make an establishment of boards and committees. And then to further on that, I was describing ad hoc committees of different sunset clauses and whatever. He said, if a board or committee is listed in the charter, it has to exist. That doesn't mean the appointing authority has to fill it, but it has to exist, so it really does. Any board or committee that's formed by one of these boards or committees can be specified as to have a sunset clause of whatever duration you want or not. There's no particular reason, there's no power between the phrase ad hoc. He said they should just be set up if they have a specific purpose and a specific time frame expected. That should just be in the setup. You know, a committee called whatever you want, you still call it ad hoc, but you don't have to define it in the chart. But the appointing authority should just specify what this group is and what it's intended to do and what time frame. And he very much was for any committee not listed to have a sunset clause, even if it's 3 or 5 years. Just to remind everyone, oh yes, this is a good thing.
Okay. That is a good way to handle that, because we have tangled up a little bit about various terminology and the names of the committees. Yes, Bill?
I still have a little problem on 213 calling it boards, because those are committees of town meeting. We don't, town meeting doesn't appoint boards, we appoint committees.
And the phrase boards or committees, Bill, is meant to be a very broad one, not necessarily meaning boards.
Okay.
Just meaning any group, and there's a list in the definition.
Okay. All right. Anything else in 2? Section 3 deals with elected boards slash committees, which I see you can add here, elected officers and boards committees. One of the things, the major change here you'll see is that in terms of 3.6, the biggest change we made is the fact that we can move the board of assessors from elected to appointed. That is now part of 4-2 in terms of the biggest change there. And my understanding is the board of assessors does agree with this, and the reason we did that is because that particular position needs particular skills. And so we decided that it'd be better in order to capture those particular skills that we can only as opposed to elect on that. In terms of the other changes, in basically most of the other changes we had cleans up some of the language. You know, if it's already stated in state law and we didn't include it here. For example, under 3.2, we eliminated to administrative policies, we eliminated that. You know, because that's already stated in state law. We changed the supports who they can appoint. The board of selectmen can appoint the town manager, town council, town accountant, not more than 5 constables. And then we said any other appointed board slash committee. We eliminated the specific reference to the recreation, council on aging, board of cemetery trustees, housing,
et cetera on that. We felt that the other appointed boards and committees would cover that. In terms of the school committee and the municipal light, one of the things we did is, and the charter actually said that each of these committees appoints either their superintendent, general manager, to fix their compensation. We changed that, we eliminated that, and just basically said that the school committee shall appoint a superintendent and shall define his duties in terms of employment. We did that also same for the municipal light, in terms of that, where that goes also at this point. And those are really kind of the major highlights that have been included here.
I would just add that some of the feedback we got from the assessors and others was that having the blue light was actually a detriment, where some people would not want to run for the office because they would be appointed to it, but did not want to actually be involved in the office.
Mm-hmm. Any other comments?
I'll just make one particular comment. Right now, the charter says the town manager shall have responsibility for the library building and grounds. Mm-hmm. So that means facilities department isn't supposed to do it, I am. So we added the board designee so that they could actually continue to do the work.
Okay. Next question. I think you noticed that when I started looking at the school charter and the board of life commissioner, where it says that you appointed the superintendent or the general manager. The trustees appoint the director. Should that be stated specifically in here?
It could be. It is stated somewhere else.
It is stated
somewhere
else.
It would be consistent to list it the same way as those other two.
Yeah, but if it could be listed consistently, that would be good.
Yeah. And we use, I'd say, the same thing. Just change the title. The superintendent or light board commission versus general manager.
Any other comments?
Just one comment on the board of assessment. I'm voting for the change, so I'm not suggesting I'm involved in change my position. One of the concerns I have is that the Board of Assessors right now is responsible and opposed because of the way it's set up. I understand about the problem of getting qualified people to run for that office, and that's what swayed me to support it. But now that they're going to be appointed by a selectman, that's who they answer to.
Same argument, I'm sure, took place 25 or 6 years ago when the treasurer collector was changed to be appointed, I would suppose. Mm-hmm. Gee, won't the town manager have undue influence over hiring someone? The fact is that both the treasurer collector, the board of assessors, the town accountant, and many others answer to much higher authorities than those in the town. It's part of their profession. So there's plenty of state law to protect you.
Okay.
That's my only one.
Yeah. To be honest, I had a similar concern. I thought everybody else outweighed it. I actually had a similar thought for you.
Yeah. Yes. The one thing that I see here is that every year it's going to come up, somebody's going to come up with reappointment. So if there's a concern, a citizen who can come to the meeting of the appointment and express their concerns.
Yeah.
The selectmen. And you know, the selectmen don't listen. No.
And you can vote that
again. And they'll have to bring a 10 issues we have.
All right, any other question on three?
I have a question.
All right, move to section 4. Bill, are you taking that one?
Yes, I did. Bill already stole part of my number, but that's all right. And I think I'll turn it on a little bit. By law, we have to have they must be certified, and if they're not certified, they can't set the tax rate, and we don't get our tax rates in the town of Vermont. That's as simple as that goes. 4-11 and 4-12, these are the town forest and the historical commission, and we felt that the Board of Selectmen should have some flexibility on that because in the past they've had a hard time trying to get people for town forest. They've had a hard time trying to get people to fill the number of seats on the commission. So we kind of left that open to them. So they can do whatever they want and establish it. And let me see what else. Article 413, which is the automatic charter review committee, I think that's great, because we won't have to rely on some town meeting member making a motion that we establish a charter commission, or hearing board of selectmen sit there for 5 or 6 years and say, gee, we should do something about the charter. And that's kind of a prompt from the idea of having a development commission. 4-14, other committees, as you refer, is still under review a little bit, I guess. 415, associate members. This was requested by the, 414, sorry. This is put on the request of the historical commission, as you may remember, when they had the hearing on the demolition delay bylaw for Summer Avenue. The only way that they had a quorum was by a phone. And we felt, and they felt that they should have, anybody who wants to be an associate member. And by law, I guess the zoning board of appeals are the only ones that can have associate members. So this was set up, and you will note in there that there's a 180-day requirement before they can be on that committee. So we thought that that was a good situation because it would prevent the appointing authority from the day before appointing somebody that might want to sway their vote one way or the other. So we thought that the 180-day was a good way to carry on that. And the rest of them, there's some smaller changes. And Bob, did you get back on 4-1 and 4-4? This is the same phrase that we use for the general law charter. Okay, yeah, the others have been chopped up. Thank you.
And I have a comment from a meeting today for recreation. 4-10. If you look at the green that's in here now, and I have no idea if it's in your copy, it might be quick, but if it is, that's amazing, but it could be. They don't want to, well, I shouldn't say that. The informal group I had in their office today thought setting up the recreation commission powers would not be the best idea because the recreation commission in most cities and towns has hire and fire power. And we didn't want to start giving that out to a board without intending to. So we reverted back to what it used to be, which is powers and duties given them by the board of selectmen who set them up, and then additional powers, the usual additional powers that might have been established. So we didn't want any unintended consequences of that phrase recreation commission. And town council had asked me what my preference was, and I said, why don't we put in commission, we'll see what happens. We found out. And on Bill's comment on 4-14, I just want to make sure you all understand that putting associate members in the charter doesn't create them. You have to then create them by bylaw. The only one that's created right now is ZBA. So if someone wishes to create associate members that can vote, it has to be a bylaw to that. But this just allows a bylaw to do it.
Is the town council on board with this wording now?
Yeah, with a little bit of change about boards or committees.
Mr. Chairman, we've been doing this so long, sometimes it's hard to figure out what's not there, but talking to a neighbor, one committee that's not on this list and is about the same size as some of these is the Ice Rink Authority.
The Ice Rink. They're independent, so not part of town government. That's an independent authority.
Established by town meeting.
It's the board of directors. It's not appointed by anyone in the town. Well, it's an ice arena authority.
Yes.
And they have a board of directors.
Yes.
It's set by a 10-year or 20-year lease contract. But none of this comes in front of anybody for appointment to the town.
Is that a good idea?
Well, that's a different question. That's the way it is.
If we recognize them in the charter, would that add?
That's a legal question as to how the lease is currently written. Doesn't mean it can't change
13, which would then make 4-ish, 414, which would make 415 other boards and committees, the 15 that you had, would make Mr. Brown's comments absolutely correct.
You're suggesting a potential 415 rise above, right?
Another section. Yes, I am.
But right, that's a proposal right now.
Yes. The language, I just asked to take a similar parallel language to the other.
Okay, I think so.
Any questions on the board? Okay, we'll move on to session five, John.
Yes, what we did was we didn't really have much about town manager before, and we added what's in red, and had a great deal of deliberation about 5-2 as to how, what appointments to cite in the charter as opposed to bylaws or what else. And then on page 22 there is a long list of powers and duties. And any comments on any of those?
Actually, Glenn does. The section 5.1 of this is the one that probably should be split out and run as a special act request, because it does relate to the appointment of the town manager. That's one of the things.
I have a question in the town council today. He'll let you know by your next meeting next month. Yeah,
I suspect that might have been. That is what we're.
I remember he said something about it that night that he was in, and then I just forgot about it.
Yeah. But that, other than that, that whole section, as near as I can tell, is open to the committee.
I can spend a lot of time on it.
Yeah.
Yes, I think we might want to point out too that the last thing in red there upon termination, that's just been moved from another section of the charter to make it more consistent. You'll find that's crossed out someplace on the board.
That's at the very end of section 5.
Yeah.
Anyone comment? On Article 5-2, with that long list of duties, what happens if you consider replacing, going back to putting some sort of a demarcation on each of the paragraphs in the sentences?
Right. I can figure out how to know.
Huh?
I probably can't figure out how to find some of them.
Yes. Right, we can take it along.
I'm looking at this list and I'm saying in the future, you know, the town meeting is going to say the fifth one down from the bottom.
Yeah, exactly.
Right?
Steve, I'm saying you might number it as 5.2.1, 5.2.2, 5.2.3,
and
everything else. But I agree, we should put something back in there.
So do you want to renumber the 5-1s, the 5.1s throughout, instead of all the dashes? It's more consistent with our legal documents.
From a bylaw point of view, I would say yes, yeah. 5 dot whatever, or and dot n.
That has to be carried through the entire.
I don't care. What you would do is you would replace whatever the hyphen is with
the
essence.
Then you fix the unintended consequences.
The only place where it gets more spectacular is 5, is what would be 5-2 becomes 5.2, and we have 5.2.1, 5.2, so on.
Yeah, that's probably better format. Consistent with the
5-2.1,
2.3, you just learned to cry a little less
than Microsoft.
We're in trust just going to show up.
Oh, what was that problem about?
I think it was downgrading Microsoft Word.
The other comment is on 5-3. small but potentially significant change, that the ombudsman should not be the town manager as it was under the previous town manager, but it should be another employee. Because if that function works, it can be an adversarial relationship where the ombudsman is speaking on behalf of a flaw in some regulation or something on behalf of a town member, and it may not be what the town manager would advocate. And there has to be dialogue. It can't just be, we'll take care of it.
I was wondering how this change came about. Now I completely understand.
And that was how it was supposed to be when it was proposed back in 2004. And it kind of got sidetracked to, well, we'll take care of it. And it was never intended to be, well, we'll take care of it.
It's almost like a constituent services position.
Exactly.
Has a dialogue with the mayor or the town manager, whether they like it or not.
Exactly. That's the intent. And the change here.
I didn't bring that forward here.
That's the last one I think we need to invite people's attention to in section 5.
I think we wanted to switch what is printed as 5-4 and 5-5. I think we want to switch those two positions. Active town manager and removal, I think we wanted to remove removal before active town manager. I think that's what we had had a
problem.
I think that's what we had voted before, and somehow now we get back to.
I'm not sure a town council liked that.
I don't care what he likes.
It's a good advice.
I don't know if it really matters. I can ask him again, but okay. Removal would also apply to an acting town manager, and it looks better if it's last.
Okay. I'll leave it alone.
Let's be positive, not negative.
All right. Positive.
Exactly. Any other comments on 5, David?
That's all I know about 5.
All right. Okay, 6. This is great. Anybody want to take this one up?
Yeah, basically what we did in 6 is, again, some of it, we had a long discussion about administrative code and what that was and what it means and so forth. So we agreed on just, you know, eliminating that and using the word table of organization that presents the organization of all town agencies. And we struck a lot of 6-1, what you can see there. And we struck it all except for the first sentence. And we kept going with it down. And one of the other things we did here is we had a long discussion about what departments should be listed. The public works was listed here and others, and we decided really that wasn't, you know, where it falls under the purview of the town manager, that we really didn't feel that was really necessary to list those anymore in terms of that, in terms of the civic departments, and we did that throughout. The other thing we had is we added some, we went through the town council, the town accountant, the town treasurer, the town collector, and the town clerk, and kind of set some duties, cleaned up some of the duties, defined some of the duties, and cleaned up some of the language in particular areas as to what we did. So,
and just let you know, we allowed for the splitting of the treasurer and the collector. Yeah. Currently, they're all positions, and they may stay that way. This way,
you wondered if she'd get 2 salaries. I said, yes, he should be happy.
And another comment I would make, and this is just historical. A lot of these bodies were mentioned, like the DPW and so forth, because in the old days, they used to be elected. The original charter commission wanted to hear what the changes were. Now, it's been 26 years. It's not going to really need to be listed again.
The only thing I would mention, it's under 6-3, you know, I noticed that town council changed from the first day of the following April to July.
I think you guys did that.
We did that.
We did that?
Yeah, we did that.
Never mind.
The other thing that town council had, and I think is great, is the vacancy of all the positions over the advice. If there's a vacancy, how it should continue. I think that's great.
one section here, but presenting a budget to town meeting where you wondered if you should put in parentheses, except our employee needs to actually, yes. You should also relook at the whole document and see if you really mean, for instance, under administrative organization, I'd now be responsible for listing RMSE on the board table, which is fine. But just understand, they are a town agency, though they are covered by that phrase.
Okay. We'll have to revisit that then.
As would the school department.
Okay. The other comments in the session. Okay. Move on to seven. Anybody want to look up that?
One of the changes we made, this is the request of the town manager, was in 7.3. He wanted a definitive date when the school committee shall submit their budget to him, so we put in at least 5 months before the start of the fiscal year, if that comes as well. And then going along with the 6-1, I think we also included it in 7-4, the budget message, and shall include a table of organizations set forth in 6-1. So that's probably the biggest change. And one of the things, one of the things that we hope that we took out on capital improvement program, we changed the word from facility and made a piece of equipment. We didn't feel it was necessary, nor I particularly had never heard the town manager tell me how much it's going to cost to repair or maintain a mower. It's over, which we buy at the cemetery department. It's in the capital plan. I really don't care. And I really don't care how much it costs to maintain a facility, except perhaps a new facility that they're looking at. But as far as replacing dump truck to dump truck, to me, it makes no difference between the cost issue we have to pay and we need. And that's probably all I can suggest on this one. I don't think there's anything else.
Well, this, I think, comes up a few times in the chatter. A minor point, but wherever we talk about publication in the local newspaper, we've changed that to the upper news media. Any other comments? Eight. I guess we can talk about some of the things we haven't taken on the vote yet.
Maybe I should take you through some of this because this is some town council thing you haven't seen.
Okay.
I wanted to take Mom and mention that in first.
Oh, yeah, before we get to that, good point. Section 9, we have virtually eliminated. In fact, we have three. I'm not sure if we did. 9 was transition provisions from going to our form of government to the town management role. We had some talk about it, meaning historical reasons, but we decided it really just clubs things up. So we ended up taking it out. None of it means anything anymore. It's not a direct aid.
We'll go through one section at a time. I don't think there's anything that's really significant. 8-1 there is just rearranging the words. It's important that you allow the town clerk to renumber things. So, for instance, this dash doesn't require a charter committee to change if you wanted to. You tell the town clerk in 3 years, hey, go do that. There's nothing else, there's nothing that's substantially changed in 8-1. Severability, that's the similar language as to what gets used in the zoning bylaw. Just basically saying if any court finds any part of this charter illegal, it will be interpreted as narrowly as possible so as not to damage the rest of the charter. Which is probably the intent of the old section, it just didn't quite say that. He didn't like the MGL abbreviation, so don't use that. Here's, we get into definitions, we get into some changes. There's no need to describe different types of committees. You know, you can do that as you set them up. And there's the board or committee phrase. Any board, committee, or commission specified in the charter create something. They can call it anything they want. Doesn't have to call it a board, a committee, a commission, a council, call it anything. And that is by legal definition, if one of those boards or committees created, they fall under this board or committee.
Can I ask one quick question?
Yeah.
Earlier you mentioned about the recreation committee versus commission.
Yeah.
That's a separate thing.
That's only because recreation commission is in Mass General Law as a specific definition. Rec committee is not.
I see. Okay.
I didn't want that. He struck some definitions that aren't important. Ex officio, sort of a little mixed up. He didn't really change it. He just got rid of the multiple member body, which he told you. I wasn't really sure, what does an ex officio mean? Does anyone really understand?
Ex officio, is a member by office.
That's what I thought.
But lacking voting, right?
No, not necessarily.
So.
But
ex officio member is a full member unless you say without board of directors.
So by virtue of his office or position means you're on a board or committee, not because anyone chose you, but because of the job you have or whatever.
Right.
Okay.
Who's appearing in the chapter?
The treasurer is on some, the town accountant is on some. I don't think any of it is specified in the chart. I'd have to do a search for the phrase. I don't remember it. It might not be there anymore. Are you out?
Is the moderator? Is the ex officio member the host?
The moderator is an ex officio member of the host.
The way it was with it.
Okay.
The moderator shall be an ex officio representative. Shall be an ex officio representative town meeting member and shall preside and regulate the proceedings.
Okay.
We have changed that.
Yeah, it may not be in the charter anymore.
Yeah.
No. It is used in the town government.
One thing on the definitions, I think we did change. We now have business day, which means the day the town hall is open for business. Because, as you know, they're not open Fridays anymore. But that could change, so.
Yeah.
If you think the word business day would be better.
I
did
want to ask a question about that. Will that have an effect now on posting meetings under the open meeting law? Because now we can count Fridays.
I think business law
had that discussion with Tom Clerk several times, and we are a lot of heads on that one, and I agree. But my feeling is that no, if they're closed Friday, and I cannot come in there to post a meeting, and that 48 hours has to take that into consideration, which she does now, and most boards do.
Yeah, mostly we do, but
right, yeah.
I'll check to make sure.
That's the reason it seems a question.
Yeah. Because if it goes back, if it goes back to Friday openings, and that's the reason I suggest the business would take instead of as it was. And we took out all the language statutes and some issues, that's understood anyway.
Yes.
No reason to have that in there.
We all set?
Oh, yeah.
No.
Okay. Let me see if this majority vote. I'm not exactly sure why, but right in here in the definitions, majority vote explains, there's another section that in the town meeting that explains majority vote means majority of those present. That there has to be a quorum. I guess the default is, in every other case, this majority vote is the definition to use, other than the town meeting. So, and Alan, you and I have sort of had this discussion with the town council. What is the charter community's opinion of what a majority vote is? If there's five board of selectmen and there's three present, what's a majority vote?
Three-fifths.
Of the four. I give my personal opinion. Well, you get the majority of those voting.
So
we get three members of the committee.
Two
vote. I'm not sure.
That's this is an important question.
Yeah, not
the charter picks
it
up.
I would argue in the reverse that if only two voted, which you've not achieved that majority, you wouldn't have a quorum.
Well, right now, if three selectmen, and this happens, if three selectmen appear and two are absent, it has to be all three voting for something to get the majority vote.
And that was the reason it was set up in the originating charter.
Yeah, but wanted to make it. The charter can change that to make it the majority of those present as long as it's quorum, just like town meeting.
Where does it say that in the charter now?
It's going to have to be right here in this section under definitions.
So right now, isn't it? That's what I'm saying, do we define it right now? It could be just, I'm thinking town meeting, that's what.
If you look at the crossed out last part of majority vote, it has all multiple member bodies, the affirmative vote of majority of all its members, so there's to be all its members. So in the case of the selectmen, that means majority vote is three.
All multiple members, and that's the way it's interpreted.
And that's the way we have interpreted it, but that's up to you guys to decide whether you want to keep it that way or not.
Okay, so it does say that.
It does. But the edited version does not say that. It says the majority of those present.
Well, yeah, I mean, I can tell you when I was chairman for life and body, basically, we're in a situation like that, we only have three members. Two voted in favor, one against, and I had to report a negative motion to town meeting in that case, because not three of the members voted in that case, or three members actually came to meet.
What if you only had three members? And there were two members to vote, it just happened.
Well, it would be, the interpretation that I was told was the fact you had to have three members voting. Even though we only had three members, only three, yeah.
And with the.
Where would you have gotten that interpretation?
That's the interpretation.
This is a bold definition.
But if you only have three members.
Well, three members, not two vacancies.
Two vacancies, three members and two vacancies.
That's five member board, three is the majority.
Right, three is what you have, three members, right.
But how are you going to get a fourth and a fifth?
In doubt, conservative, all members would be three.
No, all members is five, including two seats.
I don't see where you interpret that.
Was it simple, is that definitely?
Right there in the definition.
No, it isn't. If you only had, if you have five member body.
Well, empty seats.
Three members, two empty seats. Well, then all your members is three.
And empty seats is considered a member.
Does all the members mean five, or does all the members mean one?
It's negative.
In conservative, we interpret that to say all members mean five.
Right.
As a conservative interpretation.
Yeah, town council says you guys can decide.
Yeah.
You just have to make sure you're clear.
So if the second argument, two members of the board selected resigned and moved out of town, right, in the same day, you would now require a unanimous vote.
Right.
If three members of the board selected moved out of town, the same day.
You need a special election.
Okay.
Right. All selecting business will stop because there's time to post that in the election.
Mr. Chairman, I think this discussion gives the ample reason as to why we should change this, that majority means majority of those present and voting.
Yeah, there is a, I agree with that, should be a ten.
Jake, that's my, I think that could be the situation where two selectmen missing, that are very important voters, so explain on the vote.
That was dangerous.
My question is going to be, are we leaving in that the crossed out green has all members voting? We put that back in.
Yes.
We need to discuss that.
There's two places where this is referenced. There's this where it's in the definitions, and then in section 8-9, procedures for boards and committees, and section C of that voting. And there it describes the affirmative vote of a majority of the number of members specified in the charter or other action creating such body shall be necessary to adopt any motion, order, appointment, or approval to take any action on entirely procedural in nature. And I believe words like that were in the original charter.
I see
eight nine, the former D.
Oh,
the
old
ones, the eyes of
okay, then just specify this
guy. Okay. I somewhat agree with Dick. Perhaps a compromise would be to the elected boards have to be that majority, if you will, especially with the availability of teleconferencing today.
Yes.
I mean, it happened to a couple of selectmen meetings where somebody called me, that would be a great compromise, and I would go along with that. I strongly feel like Dick does. I think there should be a higher hurdle for the board of selectmen.
To be honest, I was actually thinking more in absence, it's not people not being there. Empty seats is a good thing. So if you have five members and two out there, I totally agree with three. More like you only have three, to me, that costs too much to come in. But it isn't the way it's written, so you're right.
Well, you could write it.
Oh, yeah, we could change it.
You could write it in the charter, but the number of seats that are filled at the time.
Well, that's a decision we have.
So then if two selectmen resign, move out down the same day, then...
If you want me to, I can send an email to the boards and committees. I don't know if you want their opinion, but...
No, I think we should...
Sorry, no, that's fine. I would tell you stories on each side of that coin where there's no obvious right answer. There's a strong 3-2 majority on the board of selectmen about something. Two of the three are out. The 2-1, I'm sorry, there's a strong 4-1 majority on a topic. Two of the four are out. It's a 2-1, it doesn't happen. That's happened in the past where one person has had veto power over the rest of the basic. Tomorrow's tax classification, one member will be out, probably a second will be out for part of the tax classification. In this case, it doesn't matter, but it could be that the remaining three in the room, only two of them were in favor of something, and they could carry the vote if it's allowed to be the lower number, even though three might oppose something. Were they there? So it's an important decision. And you can't, travel happens, you just can't tell them, like, well, you should have been there. I say remote participation does help, but doesn't always fix it.
Just extrapolating a bit on whether or not there should be different definitions for elected boards or appointed board. Let's put Vicki on the spot here and say, what library trustees, what's your view on this? Do you want them, should be a majority of whoever shows up? If you have a quorum, should be a majority of...
I mean, my personal opinion, I can't speak for the board, because we haven't discussed it. But we've always, I think, operated under the idea that it has to be majority vote of the full members of the board. It's not just a quorum.
Is that just by a precedent, or...
I think we were told that those...
I think everyone works that. Well, that's what the charter says.
Yeah, the charter says, but I mean, I understand that the board has to...
Personally, I prefer that, because I think, as Bob was saying, you can get into a situation where you can have a decision made by a minority that really isn't the feeling of the board. And with you know, remote participation, it does help.
And you can't prevent if three, let's say three selectmen show up, you can't prevent two of them, if they're the majority, of bringing up an issue and passing it right then and there. Because any issue can be brought up as an agenda item, as a disclaimer that can happen. And that can be dangerous.
That's true.
Now, should you do that? No. But could it happen?
Yes. That's one of the reasons the high rule was in the first place.
Yeah. You guys should probably think about this before you take a position. Mm-hmm.
I think so. I don't think about it. I sort of changing as I'm listening to it. I actually didn't have a strong opinion of the sound. I just always interpreted different things off. I never really looked at the details.
You'd have to interpret it your way at the town meeting where you never get in.
Right. And that's probably how I guess it's working.
Town meeting is a special case.
Yes, right.
It's a large size. Yeah.
Well, I think the higher level for the elected board in other respects. And not for the appointed boards, because the appointed boards, in most cases, are appointed by the selectors, so they're not happy with what the board didn't do. The appointed board didn't do. They wouldn't have to reappoint that person. Is that not correct?
Yeah. But the act still happens. I mean, that's sort of like closing the door at tomorrow, wherever the horse is already with. If they stack it for a vote, and the vote happens, and the selectors say, you should have done that, you're going to go out next time. I guess they will. Yeah, that works well.
I still feel that the board of selectmen or the elected board should be a higher level than the normal board.
Well, in some cases, it's less an issue. We'll take the bylaw committee or take the former water and sewer advisory board. If the bylaw committee only had three members and they voted 2-1 on something, it comes down to meeting and said, hey, the vote was 2-1.
Mm-hmm. Well,
so, from a parliamentary point of view, is not recommend the article. Town meeting can take that and weigh it out where they see fit. Likewise, on the Water Sewer Board, you might...
Well, it's advisory.
Might vote too, you know, recommends that the selectmen do something on it, the selected way. Maybe the other case is the point forward.
No, I think the way to solve that would probably be, that's a committee of town meeting, I think we can put in wording and check the committee.
I mean, it wouldn't bother me if it required a majority of the filled seats or of the chartered seats, you know, just kind of giving yourself, oh, all right, they felt 2-1.
Yeah, the only, sort of tending to leave it in there at all, but by law, it's still very technical. You've gone long periods with 4 members of the three members.
Mm-hmm.
It could be done wrong, having to have the union vote, or you two, sorry, I didn't need that.
No, yeah.
So I don't know, what do you say your opinion on that?
My opinion is conservatively, you know, the interpretation has been, you know, the majority of the file. And, you know, in order to keep ourselves out of trouble, that's how we interpret it. And that's how I think the, being on the Light Commission, I think that's how we interpret the Light Commission also. You know, so I do have 5 members.
As Fred pointed out, it's more of an interpretation, actually in the other section, it's specified, this is, you know,
me.
Yeah, at least it was before we changed it.
Yes, I see which of the chapters.
And I just want to make sure you all understand that boards that are appointed by the selectmen or others do make policy decisions. It's one thing to advise town meeting, but 2-1 vote that anyone can interpret. Quite another for the rec committee to actually make a decision that changes something on their 2-1 vote. And it's not just advisory, it's something that changes.
We should have the 2.
Town council make this decision?
I don't believe so. I don't know. He asked me the question, what's the will of the committee? I said, I don't know, because I haven't talked to him, so.
It was there before he crossed to them?
I don't remember what it was before, to be honest with you, so I just need to discuss it. And I didn't know if prior to me jumping in, if you guys had discussed this or not.
That's a good point of discussion.
Jeff, it looks like the original, where it's defining majority vote, that is from, basically from the original charter with the green strikeout was in the original charter. And that got moved to procedures for boards and committees.
Yeah, okay.
In the air voting section. Because it split the majority vote. First was specified for town meeting, the majority of those present. And then for other multiple member bodies, then the number, the majority of the number of that body. And that got taken out and added to procedures for the multiple member bodies.
Yeah.
Therefore, now you can make the case to take the majority vote totally out of the definitions.
Yes.
But in the town meeting, and then leave this one in the...
It makes sense.
Then you don't see here a definition for majority vote. It would be defined in the procedures for town meeting. It would be defined in the procedures for multiple member or boards or committees.
That's probably better.
At that point, in the boards and committees, you could then define, if you so desire, a higher hurdle for the elected ones versus the appointed ones.
I think we're through the definitions. Really general, very broad.
Yeah.
Well, I kind of like that, to get out here and we can split and more exacting.
All right. Lovely. Discuss that further. Anything else in this section?
Town bulletin boards are gone.
Oh, town bulletin boards are gone.
There was no need for 8-9. That's just complications by laws.
Okay.
Similar to 8-, the old 8-10, there was no need to have all this notification stuff in the bulletin board stuff. And then, as you recall, the new 8-10 and the new 8-12 are both subject to special acts.
Right.
But 8-11 is fine. It's just reworded. And I think it's broadened, so it's not just Board of Selectmen. so the appointing authority can do it. A board committee by majority vote probably find that and do it. And then 100 or more voters can do it. And any number of those three could happen. Now, I will say, and I haven't really heard back from town council, the key change here is removing the phrase just cause. I don't think it has to be there. But just to be clear, my version has it out because I think that's what you guys are discussing. You need to make sure that's what you need. I think it's fine. Now, I think if it's B or C, then clearly the appointing authority needs to know why is someone asking for this to happen. But if they're doing it themselves, presumably they know. But it might not be a bad idea to make them put something in writing also. And then I copied a public hearing and removal. I kind of copied what the town manager's process was and adjusted it for the fact it wasn't the town manager. So town council's reviewing this. He's looked at it quickly, no pages, but I'm sure he's going to edit it. The set of concepts are okay.
So, yeah, I mean, it kind of mirrors the language that I kind of wrote about last meeting. The only thing that, you know, doesn't seem to be here is originally stated that, you know, you couldn't recall somebody within 3 months of the original appointment. I don't see that.
That's in there or not?
Yeah.
I think he said that was not legal.
It's not legal?
The 6 month part is okay. 6 months is the end of the term. But I think you're messing around again with, well, I don't know.
Well, that helps read for elected officials too.
Right.
And yeah. Recall on elected officials talks about within 3 months of the original appointment.
I'll ask him because he specifically said that was maybe.
Yeah, the only other thing that maybe I don't see here is actually whether that it would be defined, you know, notice, I don't know if that's in here, to the individual effect.
It's in there somewhere, let me see. Just written notice thereof shall be given. Doesn't specify how. I have the last known address. You look at a public hearing, second sentence.
Written notice. Would one include their written notice hearing with the reasons for removal?
One would say.
Yeah. I mean, you could just say, you know, next Tuesday you're having a hearing, show up.
I think that thereof sort of covers, you've got to explain why.
It really kind of captures what I really was saying.
I'll ask again about that, the 6 months at the end. Is the thinking of the 6 months at the end that it's just not worth the aggravation?
That's right, exactly.
I think that's why the recall.
And the same with the first 3 months is you haven't given the first
option. That's right.
Yeah. It seems like you always the lawyers.
Yeah, I don't remember why.
Yeah, that's the same way that the recall elected officials.
He might have
the same language.
Yeah, I don't know what he said. Yeah. A few times I asked him, is this legal? He said, no, it's really a bad idea. I don't remember if this is not.
Okay.
I didn't know he had such opinions.
All right, any other comments on it?
We're going to discuss that at the next meeting.
Yeah, the things I've got that we need to put some votes on, well, all of such a. But the adding in the words, the wording of the library card to be appointed.
Yeah.
Formatting with the 1.3 type of agency, you've got to figure out if you want to reword that because it doesn't include an article of the school department. Majority of it, that's, and then you're going to ask a few questions to town council. Didn't record all of those. Maybe Dick did. Any other discussions about the charter in general, either by the public or committee?
I suggested at the end that you remove all that, I don't know what it's called, appendix of reference, the lookup stuff. I don't think you need
the
index. The
lookup? Oh, the
index.
Index.
That's all manual work, and I can see the point. I'll take that.
And with search engines now.
Technology now.
What's
except
that?
Except for Bill, and Bill, I'll look up anything.
I'll find it.
That's sure.
I know who
that was. I don't know, that was 7 to 10 pages of the document. It's not a document.
All right, I'll put that on the list to vote.
Yes. What do we figure out on the majority vote? Is that going to be melded in with?
Well, we have to decide if we want to change the interpretation, but
I do like the idea, well, it's up to us, but the idea of defining it, the town meeting, and defining it, the board's committee.
Oh, yeah.
Is that what you were asking?
Yeah, I think we should.
Yeah, that seems like.
Find the two of them.
Yeah, seems like a lot, because there are differences.
The original one in section 8, where it said majority vote, that was from the original charter. And it separated the two levels.
Right.
You know, a majority of those present for town meeting vote. And a majority of the number of members for a board committee.
I also.
And that was there defined in that. For some reason, it was suggested that with the voting for a board committee, then later on in section 8, the voting for that committee was moved into that. Committee procedures. Now, the other potential option is to take the majority vote completely out of the definitions and put it in the procedures for town meeting in Article 2. And then you have there someplace, majority vote, you know, how town meeting section fit right in section 4 of the town meeting session.
Yeah.
Majority vote of those present shall constitute affirmative action.
I think that would go along with the idea of committees there a lot of town meeting too. Because you've got two committees that are at town meeting. I think that should apply to them also.
Mm-hmm.
And it should also be stated in the charter.
Jeff?
If you're going to be defining it for town meeting, is there some definition that exists already in state statute? Regarding the members of the majority vote.
Yes, the majority is its fault.
I think I was putting it in there. If you go to find.
I just wish we're not contradicting something that's already supported us.
Yes.
What is town meeting thanks for all?
Majority of votes voted.
Majority of those voters?
Yeah. Not even majority of the majority of votes voted. So if you have 100 people at the meeting, and
right,
if it's 3-2, do you win?
And that's one of the referendum procedures, which we can't do this process. It has to be specialized. He did suggest that specifically the majority of those voting on that question, not just present and voting at the election, which is what our default was at the last time. No. You should have it be of those voting on the question. Because people show up and it's two questions. You know, you might have a lot of people voting on the first question and then just skip the second one. But you want to make sure, you know, I've got that 20% rule about whether it counts or not. Whether it passes or fails, the 20% separate has to be of those that voted on the question, not of those that show up in the election. And that was a little bit of a nuance that we may have. We've only had referendums one thing on at a time, so it really doesn't matter, but it could.
Yeah, right.
And the other thing that town council did, I think it was town council, it may have been the zoning advisory committee, that I thought was really effective, was don't put anything in the definitions that's really important, and if someone doesn't read it, they can't do something, or understand. It's only meant to clarify what a term is. It's not meant to define something important that otherwise should be somewhere in the document. So if there was plenty of zoning stuff that was in definitions that was really important, that it would be somewhere in the document, but it was only in the definitions. He said, you don't want to do that. You really want to make sure that the majority vote comes to mind. If it's important to a section, that it's be understood in the section, explain it in the section. It's really only a reference. In this document especially, it's hardly any definitions. It's a dozen or so.
Yeah.
What I haven't asked town council is there definitions that are missing? You guys all look at the definitions, I think we should, between all of us, come up with an answer to that. I don't know.
Knowing that too.
There's a point where we have to make a determination. Yeah.
The only other thing that no one really discussed was RMLD and the fact that we are not changing anything other than the name of commissioners for now. Well, if there's some minor changes. What's the discussion going to be about that? Is there a next step or it's just not going to happen?
I'd wait until after all the investigations over, then I'll have to do something next year.
Okay.
And my thought would be, quite frankly, I'd be willing to make it a town meeting. Let's establish and get another committee, two members of the Board of Selectmen, two members of the Light Department, and then
whatever, three town meeting members or three citizens at large, and let them come up with a compromise between everybody.
I think you should be prepared as a group to just answer any question that comes up about, aren't you going to do anything on this, or did you consider?
Yeah.
Because there is a, both legal councils are involved in it.
Yeah, I know.
You know, I think the best thing to do is put us all on a room, lock the door.
Yeah, that's why.
And see if we can come up with a solution.
That's why I suggested committee 5 or 7, and let you do that.
Right.
I think it needs more time, so, rather than just a few boards.
Right, and I think the commission, I can only speak for myself, but I think the commission would kind of agree with that.
Yeah.
To lock us in a room and see if we can solve it.
But unfortunately, we have to go to the 5:30 open meeting.
Well, we'll lock the audience in too.
I agree with you.
The board of selectmen would also agree with that.
What would be the way of making that happen?
Instruction motion at town meeting.
Or not any action by this board?
Well, no, but it could be an instruction.
You could make one.
A feeling has been that we need a law.
Because my guess is, and I'll answer for the selectmen, they're waiting to see what we do. They're not going to do anything or start a meeting plus this investigation. But they had spoke about, can you put RMLD on the agenda? And I said, when? Well, they said, that's a good question. We have a charter committee that's done it now, we have the finance committee. And I suspect the commissioners are similar.
It certainly would help if this committee recommended that step out there.
And I'll make the motion at town meeting if you want an instruction motion that when we come up, we'll make it in November for that matter.
I just want to express my frustration that we haven't been able to move something on this. I'm on record saying that I'm actually not in favor of putting this off and having another committee of a couple of people here, a couple of people there, and looking at it. We talked about the notion of, you know, putting a bunch of people in a room and closing the door. Well, if that's recognized as the, you know, potential solution, I don't see why that can't be done right now. I think we'll just give them language to try to. I think we're wasting time on this. I think what's in the charter currently makes perfectly good sense. It's a matter of how it gets interpreted and put in place. To me, it's a very common sense a requirement that's there. It has the necessary exclusions for things that don't make sense. And if we need to exclude some other things that didn't make sense, that could be done. But you know, I'm extremely frustrated that I've seen nothing but legal posturing and stonewalling. I think we need to move on with this and try and make some progress.
I just have one. I don't particularly care how you proceed, but I would ask you and advise you that if you want to discuss this in the near term, that would be a separate article. So the whole thing doesn't based on that part. So that you can add this to January town meeting, have it be a standalone article. And then you can, between now and then, do whatever you want in the process to come up with a solution. You know there's going to be debate and acrimony, and I just would hate to see the whole thing die affected by it. Yeah.
And the bottom line, quite frankly, is the fact that the two legal councils are on loggerheads, and this potentially could be a litigious issue.
Sure.
I'm sorry to say that. But it could end up in the courts, and I think, you know, locking us all in a room and see what kind of the solution, and maybe avoid legal costs for both the town and the RMLD.
That was my thought for the whole thing.
Right.
As I read both sides of the story, one contradicts the other and says, well, this is the law, the other says, this is the law. I don't feel comfortable sitting here, having read all that material, trying to put something in the chat. I quite frankly would feel better if Bob suggested that we form yet another committee, if you will, an AA committee. But just to separately take care of that. And then that can come up in November if you want to make a structural motion. Or wait until we come up with this one and do it. I
We've been, what, 10 years now with the debate on this thing? Another year or so, we really doesn't see that much. And going with what Phil's saying, I've known this whole thing too. I think we're just going to end up in a court case out of this whole damn thing, and I don't think it's financially worth it to leave the site to do this. Plus, the way it is, the end of time, it can end up being very costly.
No, I guess I'm saying the same thing. If we, let's just say we ask town council to write something that we will put in here, that where he wrote and we approved, I think we probably would end up in some sort of litigation. And, you know, I just hate to get involved in that. It doesn't make any sense.
And I think, you know, the commission would probably, you know, when I'm going to get the selectmen, if we could sit down and see if we can come up with something in the middle of it, probably glad to have you on the committee, if you want to serve in the committee. You know, I'm on that.
Yep.
Well, I'd rather make a subcommittee of this committee to do that.
Well, Paul, do you have a specific proposal?
I don't want to put you on the spot.
For me, when town council came in and said, gee, you know, RMLD basically has been in compliance by adapting some of their policies and whatever else. And the sticking point seems to be the 30B issue. And pardon my, you know, engineering sense, but I can't imagine why you wouldn't want to have good controls on your purchasing. And it doesn't say you have to follow 30B to the letter. It leaves exceptions or whatever else. And so by simply demonstrating that the policies have been updated in such a way to do the common sense things that are there, I just don't understand why that can't happen. And I've seen nothing in you know, any of the legal briefs that have come out that have offered anything of an instructional motion or method that says, you know, if we did this, you know, this would be acceptable. Or, and I'm sorry, so I'm just not happy with the way, you know, things have gone so far. And as far as you know, the issue of a legal battle, okay, you know, I feel like a board, specifically in this case the Board of Light Commissioners, is putting a gun to the town's head. No, I'm threatening that okay, you know, so we're gonna, you know, do this battle.
And I strongly disagree that
pains me greatly to hear that.
I strongly disagree that we're putting a gun to anybody's head. I mean, it's an option that we have.
Then don't threaten litigation.
I mean, if we, and I, you know, I think the idea would be to sit down and try to avoid it. We can sit down in advance and avoid it. You know, I think that'd be the way to go.
I think the selectmen would be more than willing to sit down. I wouldn't quote you odds if we could solve the problem with this closed door session.
Well, yeah, I mean, I
think it's a discussion.
I agree with that.
Because there are selectmen who are going to take your opinion, your position.
Yeah.
So they're not going in. But let's see if we can work it out amongst ourselves. What's the real issue?
There could very well be a middle ground.
And whether or not anybody's putting a gun in anybody else's head, I think it's important we not be hasty in coming with a solution. The question came up about why not maybe a subset of this body. It seems to me it's better if you bring in some of the Board of Selectmen and some of the RMLD. And hash out and figure where the issues really are, sticking points really are, or not, or what we can agree on, what some of the long-term consequences of a different thing might be.
And it gets a little money, I'll say, when you think of all the parties involved, because the town of Reading is both the owner, if you will, and the customer. We have two seats at that table. There's three other towns that have a similar seat to us as customers.
That's right.
What role does the customer play in this discussion? That's a fair question. It's not the typical kind of customer. You know, you can ignore most customers. customers. These are four pretty important customers.
60% of the life of the customers are outside of Redmond.
So that's why I think it's a simple issue with very complex circumstances.
Yeah. And, you know, not everybody here has lived through the two votes in one to fill out the system and what that could mean. Some of us have.
Jesse. Well, ultimately, I think the reason we're talking about it all is that there's Section 325 to either change or be alone, and that's the part of your risk committee. If it's got to include, I guess, a lot more discussion throughout the town, I think the subcommittee of this committee is perfect for that, because you can draw in, people from Latin, both legal sides, and then you get everybody in that room. I just think getting 12, you're trying to make a decision with 12 people, it's going to be a little ponderous. I also think it would be much more better to get a specialized committee going right at that one issue, and then reporting back to this committee to take the issue.
I don't feel that I have the expertise, quite frankly, to go into that deep. That's why I'm suggesting a separate committee later on of just the selectmen, two members of the board, like commissioners, and three citizens at large. And there may be some citizens out there that have a hell of a lot of knowledge. I can think of one. Quite frankly, it probably would do some all that and come to compromise. I don't see the need for this one being litigation. And it could be from either side. And Phil was saying from their side, but also to be from the town side. And the board of selectmen said, well, how would you, we're going to take it a foot on it, then it's the town side. They don't like that 30 feet watch.
And the other thing that I'm concerned about is our town table.
Yeah. So this could be our section one. That's why I'm not getting down in that one.
Yeah, that's why I'd ask you to be careful about the January schedule of this issue.
I think we're almost at the point right now we can wrap this up very shortly.
We've got it.
They've sent you up.
Well, maybe 3 meetings.
Yeah. Right. They sent them on the RMD thing, and I think that should not be a stopgap.
Yeah. So then it doesn't become a subcommittee of this committee, which is a new committee. It might happen to include some of the members who are on this committee.
Right, absolutely.
Or
yeah, no reason to charter change when you appear next year.
Right.
So the changes that you have suggested is just, if you will, superficial, changing the name to include all commissioners. And there's a couple other things.
That's just another to be filled in to be 30 years. How do you follow that? That's not very good.
Well, we've come to the end of the document. Do you have any comments? If I ask our public commission?
What's your plan going forward in terms of next Monday? I think you'd be in a position to vote the final document. There's a couple questions you asked me that I don't need to get you information on.
With the exception of the RMV,
the exception of RMV.
We've got six things to vote. None of them seem to be ready.
Yeah.
We could be in a position to vote the final document.
So if you do that, I don't think it's necessary for you to be there next Monday. But if you do vote a final document, town council will then review it.
Yes.
And then at your future meeting, which I don't even know that we've actually scheduled later in the
first is the
24th.
December 1st is the last one. We only have that
post. Was there a November 24th?
Yeah. November 24th, I'm sorry, yes.
So November 24th. In theory, if town council, and it won't take that long since he's already reviewed it, but you just can't meet. On the 24th, you could see what he's done, if as much, and then agree to that.
Yeah.
And that would be in time for the selectmen to close the warrant. Just so you know, they changed their schedule a little today. It can be either the 2nd or the 9th, but I wouldn't mind if they saw it on the 2nd and then voted articles on the 9th so they have some time to digest the charter changes. So that I would like them to close the warrant on December 2nd, if it's possible. If it isn't, they'll do it on.
We have a potential committee meeting on December 1st.
Right.
Not posted the last time.
Right.
So maybe we should post that just.
And then it's an open question whether this committee wants to get involved and have a meeting, because they would inform in terms of how to do a presentation at town meeting. The you and I can work on that, or you guys can join up, whatever you want.
Yeah, yeah.
I have a lot of scars because if I know how the zoning, when it's going to be done, I'm going to be there for 3 years. it's just phenomenal amount of work. This is a lot of work, but it's a lot more digestible. I think your document can be presented in bold and strike out if you want to. Theirs could not. There's just no way.
I think we should.
But in addition to this, we need, and I'll create this, some kind of an explanation of why. What changed and why? So is it just wordsmithing? Is it an actual change, like Board of Assessors is now appointed on elected? So someone on the set guides at the change, and they can lead us side by side with the whole process.
It just is a practical matter. The chairman of the committee, moderator,
yeah, right. And you will have to decide, you're going to have, let's say, 5 articles. Who's going to present the articles? I can do it if you want. You could, you guys can do it. You shouldn't do it. Maybe you refuse yourself from that.
That's a good question.
We're not voting, so I don't think you'd have to, but.
Right. That really been trying to act as a moderator, as opposed to the chair. So we could, I'd say next meeting, we could discuss all of these and then decide what we want to do.
Okay.
We discuss what things that we should make decisions on next meeting. And the library director, I use it formatted, just basically simple, because we're at 1.2.3 at that level. We're going to look at the word agency and see if we need to exclude the RLD and school department in places. Define the majority vote, I guess, is we're going to do in 2 separate places. Decide whether we remove the index or not. We all should, between now and then, look at the definitions to see if we can mistake it or we have things in there that shouldn't be in there. And then make a decision whether or not we make a decision about the RLD. That's unfair. And then you have 2 or 3 things you're asking to talk about. Yes,
I feel consensus, quite frankly. Let's exclude the RMLD, so I'd like to make a motion that we exclude that right now. If that's acceptable?
Yes, by excluding, you mean not making any changes other than superficial?
Other than superficial.
All right, so there's a motion, we have a second?
Second.
Okay, any further discussion on that?
Yes.
Motion.
I'd like to read the thing,
Let's be able to vote on next week. We'll go back and have it. We will bring it up next week.
Okay,
we'll take a vote on it.
Is there a motion made?
Yes. So why don't you know? I think what we should say is a motion made and second, and we will discuss it at the next meeting.
RLD.
Yes.
Make a decision.
Yeah.
Make a decision.
Okay. RLD.
Jeff, move the table on next meeting.
Jeff will
take that. That was Bill Brown, and who's that?
John Happen.
Okay. Is it voted unanimously, I guess?
No, they don't know what's going on.
There's no vote.
Then we have the motion to table, the motion until next week.
The vote.
And Phil seconded that. So we will take a vote on tabling that motion until next week.
Yeah.
All those in favor? Those opposed? Okay. So we will discuss it. There was a motion on table. We'll discuss that along with the other 5, 6 points.
I want to try to break it to the 5.
So, Jenny, I guess I'm
going to do this.
Join this, yeah. And I was trying to do across the table. But they're just the things that I've been writing down from the comments. Right. Things that we just need to clean up. All right, anything else? John?
Move the hearing to be closed.
Sir, second?
Questions? I'd like to thank the audience for coming.
Did you have to fight in your chair?
Yes.
Okay. We'll make it park until
we saw that park.
We'll take care of it. I know somebody in town.
Okay, we have a motion.
We're going to have to play racket for later on.
We have a motion to close the hearing. All those in favor?
Is
it closed?
Yes.
All right.
Thank you.
Thank you.